Hello then, welcome to the PX series. Over a period of 9 episodes, we're smashing engine cases, dropping screws, mounting stuff the wrong way. But most importantly, you will learn how to rebuild your own Vespa engine. And now, it's my duty and honor to introduce you to Andre from SIP, who is going to guide you through the whole process.
Hello and welcome to the SIP Tutorials channel. My name is Andre and I am happy to present you the assembly of a Vespa PX engine today. This engine is representing and more or less similar to all kinds of large frame Vespa engines. It also is more or less similar to other Vespa engines, and we know that there are probably a million different ways to build an engine, but we hope that you could find some tricks and some hints which make it easier for you to build your own Vespa engine, and we're gonna show it to you today. For this engine build, we prepared a list which will guide us through the process of assembly of the engine. It gives different torque values for the different screw types, and we are filling the list together. For your own engine build, for you at home, you can download this list underneath the video screen. There is a small link in the description area. First thing I like to start with is the main shaft. When we put the main shaft out of the engine we already have, then first thing we will check is the clearance of the gear plates. They have a small clearance, and probably worn engines have around 0.5 millimeter of clearance, but the target value of Piaggio says it is to be between 0.1 and 0.4 millimeters. SIP has this perfect feeler gauge, which makes it easy to check the clearance between the gear discs by pushing it between these shims on the side of the gear plates. So let's say I found out it has 0.4 clearance, which is the maximum of play which should be there. So I open the main shaft clip and take off the gear plates. On the sides of the gear plates you have these spacer shims, which are available in different thicknesses, and by changing the thicknesses you can adjust the clearance to a total of 0.1 millimeter. Also, whenever you're rebuilding this main shaft, you will change this cruciform, because it is a piece that is easily worn out, especially if you have an engine with high performance. You put it to the main shaft, and there are holes on one side which make it possible for you to turn it. We turn it, put it down. Next thing, we are going to take the gear selector bolt, apply some thread lock on it, put it inside. It has a left hand thread, and we're going to fix the cruciform with that. The proper value of tightening torque is around 30 newton meters. Unfortunately, it's impossible for me to apply a torque meter here, but this is really tight. I believe this could be 30 newton meters. Now I put on the gear plates, always with the higher side upside. Once I put the locking washer on the circlip on this main shaft, I'm checking the clearance again. Now with the new shims, it should be to the target value, close to the target value of 0.1 millimeters. I'm pushing it in, and the 0.1 feeler gauge is fitting easy. The 0.15 feeler gauge is also still fitting. The 0.2 will probably fit hard. Yes, it takes a lot of force, so the clearance will be up around 0.15 millimeters, which is okay. If you find that you have different clearance on different measuring points, on different measuring locations, it belongs to the gear plates are not 100% exactly parallel. But this is kind of normal. Just take a medium value of what you measure. So in this case, I write down the tightening torque I applied to the cruciform, and I also write down the lateral clearance my rebuilt main shaft has. Now the main shaft is finished. It's ready to be assembled into the engine.
Alrighty, next video we'll show you how to assemble the secondary shaft. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. Plus activate the bell so you won't miss out on any future projects.